Hi everyone, my name is Larissa. I'm a neurobiologist and a person with Charcot-Marie-Tooth disease or CMT. This is yet another video in the series called Supplements and CMT. My conclusions on this topic, just like any other, is based on scientific evidence and not subjective opinions. Therefore, today I'm going to cover if there is any scientific evidence suggesting that taking coenzyme Q10 as a supplement can help CMT. Let's go. I remember TV commercials advertising supposedly anti-aging face creams like this one containing coenzyme Q10. This was back in the early 2000s when I was a teenager in Russia and had no idea that I would get interested in science. Since then, coenzyme Q10 somehow lost its popularity as an ingredient in cosmetics, but gained its popularity as a supplement taken by people to treat all types of conditions. People with CMT2 often take Q10 as a supplement either because it was prescribed to them by their doctors or simply because they heard it helps. But first of all, what is coenzyme Q10, also known as ubiquinone, CoQ and CoQ10? Well, it is a lipid mostly present in the inner mitochondrial membrane. In fact, 80% of Q10 is located in the mitochondrial membrane of our cells. You might remember that mitochondria are powerhouses of our cells. The main job of these organelles is to produce energy in the form of ATP. Please watch my video about creatine supplementation and CMT to learn more about ATP as the energy currency of the cells. The way mitochondria synthesize ATP is via a series of reactions that involve several protein complexes, which create a flow of electrons through the so-called electron transport chain, as shown in this picture. Here is the mitochondria. It has an outer and an inner membranes. In the inner membrane, you can see a series of enzymes such as NADH and FADH2. These are electron donors, which pass electrons to electron acceptors until finally electrons are picked up by oxygen and water is formed. Each reaction in this chain releases energy, which is then used to generate a proton gradient across the mitochondrial membrane by pumping protons into membrane space. Protons are then pumped from the intermembrane space into the mitochondrial matrix by ATP synthase, and ATP is produced from ADP. Coenzyme Q10, circled in red in this picture, plays an important role in this process. It picks up electrons from complex 1 and 2 and transports it to complex 3. That's why it's called a coenzyme. It's a cofactor for other enzymes. So Q10 was discovered when the researchers were trying to understand the electron transport chain, which I just described, and was first isolated from beef heart mitochondria by Dr. Frederick Crane in 1957. It then became clear that ubiquinone, or Q10, is present in all living forms, hence the name ubiquitous quinone, and it is an essential molecule for our mitochondria to function as intended. In the 80s, many clinical trials were launched to see if Q10 supplementation could help different conditions, especially heart failure, as the disease severity significantly correlates with Q10 deficiency. I was actually surprised to learn that the efficacy and safety of this coenzyme Q10 in the treatment of congestive heart failure is well established by now, but as an additional treatment, not as a substitute for the traditional medicinal treatments. It is important to mention that Q10 also has antioxidant properties. I would like to note here that in the previous videos, I reviewed some other antioxidants such as melatonin and curcumin and their potential benefits for people with CMT. In those videos, I explained why antioxidants could be beneficial for people with CMT, including CMT1A. I also explained what an antioxidant is. Coenzyme Q10 exhibits antioxidant and anti-inflammatory properties and therefore is an attractive therapeutic candidate for CMT in this regard. So what about the studies in CMT? Well, several studies suggest a potential beneficial effect of Q10 supplementation for CMT. The first study I could find was published in 1985, and it estimated the efficacy of Q10 supplementation in people with different muscle diseases, including CMT. However, this is important, the rationale of this study was that people with myopathies often have cardiac dysfunction, and so Q10 might help with this, thus improving the overall health status. In this study, there were only 4 patients with CMT. They were treated for 3 months with 100 milligrams daily of coenzyme Q10 and a matching placebo in a double-blind trial. This patient's cardiac function was improved in the group taking Q10 supplements. Blood level of Q10 also increased after Q10 supplementation. Subjectively, one of the CMT patients noticed improvement in their walking and leg control. Now, it is a very old study, as I mentioned, 1985, with a small number of participants, especially participants with CMT, only 4 people. We don't know which type of CMT these people had. And the cardio function improved in Q10 group, but it's not like it was severely dysfunctional in these patients in the first place. In fact, when I looked at the parameters that the researchers checked, which were cardiac output, stroke volume, and heart rate, and compared them with the normal ranges, people with CMT were within normal ranges even before Q10 supplementation. So in my opinion, it's very hard to interpret the study results considering all the above mentioned points. There is another paper by the same group of researchers published in 1995, so 10 years later, which summarizes the results of the 1995 trial that I just described and an additional double-blind trial. In this second trial, there were only 3 patients with CMT among 15 total participants, and the others had the other diseases. The results were very similar to the first trial of 1985, including less fatigue and improved physical performance after Q10 supplementation in the subjects with CMT. The authors also mentioned that 100 mg daily is probably too small of a dose, and a higher percentage of 300 or even 400 mg of Q10 is needed to achieve better results. Again, old study, only 3 patients, hard to make conclusions. Then, in a more recent study of 2012, Japanese researchers tried giving a higher dose of Q10, 200 milligrams daily, to a patient with CMT. It was a 37-year-old patient with a mutation in mitofusin 2 gene, MFN2, which causes CMT2A. This type is often characterized by visual impairment, and this patient also had optic atrophy, as confirmed by some tests by these researchers. Because this type of CMT is caused by mutations in the gene playing an important role in mitochondrial functioning specifically, the researchers decided to give him Q10 supplementation. They observed that after 8 months of taking Q10, the patient's vision improved, but there was no muscle or sensory improvement. The researchers conclude the article by saying that a large-scale study is required to assess the potential benefit of Q10 supplementation in CMT. But I couldn't find any of such studies published since then, unfortunately. There is a case report of 2021 about a 27-month-old child with a developmental leg with a mutation in MORS2 gene, which causes CMT2Z. The researchers decided to give the child a mitochondrial cocktail, so-called, which, among others, included Q10. Here you can see the list of different compounds, different ingredients that were included in this mitochondrial cocktail. So the child was taking this cocktail for 5 days in the hospital and a month after they discharged the child. No improvements were observed, and the researchers make a conclusion that this mutation in the MORS2 gene has nothing to do with mitochondrial dysfunction. So that's why the cocktail didn't help. So one conclusion we might make is that perhaps Q10 supplementation is beneficial for some type of CMT, especially those that are caused by mutations in mitochondrial genes, such as MFN2 that I just mentioned before. But again, that needs to be established in large-scale trials, which have not been conducted yet, unfortunately. It is true that there are some studies suggesting beneficial effect of Q10 supplementation in diabetic neuropathy or Duchenne muscular dystrophy, but these are different diseases, right? And their mechanism is different from CMT. Plus, I do not know of any disease that is treated by Q10 supplementation. Yes, sometimes doctors prescribe Q10 supplementation as a like additional treatment, but it is not a primary treatment for any of the muscular disorders or heart diseases and CMT as well. Here, I would like to finish the video by saying that, interestingly, there is a type of axonal CMT which is caused by mutations in CoQ7 gene. So the CoQ7 enzyme catalyzes the second to last step in the coenzyme Q10 biosynthesis pathway. And because this enzyme is so important for Q10 synthesis, for this type of CMT, Q10 or its derivatives supplementation might make sense, as the researchers also suggest in some papers that are specifically devoted to this type of CMT. Although again, I couldn't find any trials testing this, but just kind of logically, it might make sense that in this specific type of CMT, supplementation with Q10 might help. Although again, what makes sense logically doesn't necessarily make sense physiologically and biologically. So that's why I'm always insisting on the fact that any supplement, any drug should be tested in a larger number of people before we can make any conclusions. Finally, let me just mention that a coenzyme Q10 supplementation might be beneficial if there is a deficiency, which can be checked by doing a blood test, for example. So as researchers say, coenzyme Q10 deficiency may be caused by insufficient dietary Q10. We get Q10 from our diet. Impairment in Q10 biosynthesis due to some diseases, for example, and excessive utilization of Q10 by the body, or any combination of these three factors. In fact, many nutrients are necessary for Q10 synthesis, as you can see in this picture. So I could not stress it enough. A healthy diet and rich in these nutrients is the key. So of course, it's up to everybody to decide whether they want to supplement, whether they want to take Q10 supplements, but my personal opinion now, based on all the studies that I reviewed, is that there is not enough evidence to recommend Q10 supplementation for people with CMT with any type. But it logically makes sense that it might help for those types that are caused by mutations in the genes involved in mitochondrial function. For other people with CMT and in general, a healthy diet rich in nutrients, which will ensure that you have all the necessary nutrients for Q10 production, is necessary. So I hope this video was helpful. Please like this video, subscribe to my channel, write in the description below whether you are taking Q10, whether you're considering taking Q10, and if this video helped you decide. Okay, I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.